All right, we're going to take a look at this region here, and we're going to rotate that region now around the line x equals 5. Now, x squared is just a parabola. We'll say it looks something like that. X equals 2 is here, and x equals 3 is here. Y equals 0 is just the x-axis. So the region in question looks like that. But we are now going to rotate this around the line x equals 5. To do that, you'll notice really quickly that it's not convenient to use the washer or the disk method, because the inner and outer radius using the washer method changes depending on your y value. So instead, we're going to use the shell method. With the shell method, if we're rotating around the line x equals 5, we need to split up our region vertically. Each one of these shells is then going to have a width of dx, and we're going to rotate each one of those shells around that line like that. We can then add up all of the volumes of these thin shells between x equals 2 and x equals 3 to find our volume. Now again, the volume of each one of these shells is just going to be 2 pi r h, that's the surface area of a shell, times in this case the width of the shell, which is dx. Now the radius of each one of these shells that we're looking for, you'll notice, is not just x. It's actually this entire length 5 minus whatever this x we choose is. In other words, our r is going to be equal to 5 minus x. And we're going to plug that r in right here into that integral. The height is a little bit easier. No matter where we choose our x, our height is going to be given by the function x squared. So our height is just x squared. We'll plug that into the integral right here, and let's see what happens. As far as limits of integration go, you'll notice that our x values that we choose can be anywhere from 2 to 3. Now let's complete this problem by finishing up the integral. I'm going to multiply the x squared through the parentheses, and now we can integrate, and we can plug in our limits of integration from 2 to 3. We can simplify a little bit. Let's see, one of the 3's in the denominator here is going to cancel with one of the 3's in the numerator. That's going to give us 5 times 9, which is 45. 3 to the 4th power is 81. 2 cubed is 8, which we can multiply by 5 to get 40/3. And 2 to the 4th is 16, which we can divide by 4 to get 4. Combining all these fractions in the parentheses gives us 185/12, which we can then multiply by 2 pi to get 185/6 pi. That is a volume, so it's going to be in units cubed. And that is the final answer to this problem. Let's take a look at the whole thing here. Cool, I hope that helps.